Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do my October monthly spread. I am all set up with the small packs of Happy Planner stickers. I'm looking for, like I always use, the large blank squares or rectangles to be able to use to write on. So I thought I would check these first. And I also have one of the washi tapes from my Sunshine Sticker Co. Bullet Bundle. And I do have my Happy Planner stickers and my other stickers kind of sitting off to the side. It just kind of depends on how I'm feeling. I'm going to start though with the larger stickers so that I am able to build off of that and see what color scheme I'm interested in using and go from there. All right, let's get started. Okay, right off the bat, I went looking for the largest stickers. I look for the large blank stickers to be able to start the layout because then, of course, I can build around it and build up to the smaller spaces. So I think that I found quite a few in the smaller, I don't know what these little tiny Happy Planner packs are called, just these little ones you see sitting here off to the side. And I was also visiting with one of my girlfriends at the same time. And I think I did this really fast considering that I was visiting with her. It looks like I started first with some washi tape. This is washi tape from the Sunshine Sticker Co. Bullet Bundle. That's the one that I messed up the address on. Totally all on me, but I love this. It's little tiny arrows in a different colorway. So I grabbed some of the sticker boxes that have large empty spaces and started laying them down. And you can see in this video that I am a person that talks with my hands. As I'm talking, you can see, even though I am laying down stickers, sometimes I pause and I'm like gesturing and things like that. And like I said, I was visiting with one of my girlfriends at the same time. So that was really fun. I really enjoy bullet journaling with a friend. She and I live together. Sorry, we didn't live together, obviously, but we lived near each other when we were both in Ghana. And we got together. I don't remember how often we got together back then. We might have gotten together like maybe once a month or every like 3 weeks. And we did our bullet journaling. She used, and I think still uses, a pre-printed planner. And of course I use, right now I'm using the Leuchtturm bullet journal, the A5 blank notebook. And I'm still kind of trying to decide what I'm going to use next year. I feel very conflicted because there's just so many choices and yeah, I don't know. I'm definitely going to, you know, be recording things as I go along the way. But as I got started, you see, I use another grocery list sticker. I used a grocery list sticker back in September as well. And I'm not sure if I ended up covering it up in September. I don't think I did, actually. I need to grab my bullet journal. I think it's downstairs as I'm recording this. I don't think I covered it up, but I don't really care that the header says that. I do end up covering it up for the October one, for this spread, but I did not cover it up for my September. It doesn't bother me. I'm looking for the space to write things, and I'm looking for the large stickers. I was actually looking back through my planner the other day when I was kind of filling things in, and I was looking at my spreads for my creative projects and also for using up my fabric. I will showcase those in another video. I do have some ideas for what I want to put forward for my journal for next year. And I'm keeping probably most of what you see in terms of like 2 pages a month for October. Sorry, 2 pages a month for each month. I mean, I think it's going to be the weeks that I might do a little bit differently. The amount of space that I have for each day is proving to not be enough space. But also I kind of think about like where I am in the season of my life. And for this fall, for September and October, I'm taking 2 classes in an accelerated semester. So I have a ton of work to do, not only for school, but of course the typical work that you do around the house and like for your family and just for myself and my volunteering and things like that. So right now the spaces that I have are not enough, but it's kind of like it's too late because I set up my journal. I set up my entire year, like at the beginning of the year. So I already have the spaces marked out. I do have some space at the back of the journal. I think I probably have about maybe 20 pages left I don't actually have a lot of pages. I used up almost all of it. But I am thinking about for next year, what kind of system am I going to need and stuff like that. So here you see how many spaces do we have now. I think I've got 9 or 10 right now. And I think I just add a couple more smaller writing spaces that kind of fit into this area. And then I start decorating it with the larger deco. I did a lot of layering this time. I ended up finding smaller deco stickers that have like, I don't know, a lot of them are transparent, which is kind of cool. I appreciate being able to like lay stuff down and then still seeing the pops of color from behind. And yeah, I really like this spread. I feel like it is not super bright in your face, but definitely very colorful. You know, I've got nearly every shade in here. Blue is absolutely my favorite color. And I try to just kind of get out of that of only using my favorite color or only using like the same color. That's why I try to also use multiple sticker books or multiple stickers so that I am able to find that variety and be able to showcase that in these spreads. Because, you know, I think in another video I mentioned I look at them daily. I'm not sure that I look at them daily so much as I look at it, you know, a few times a week to check in with myself. Hey, did I actually do something on this list so I can like check it off? Don't forget to do some of the self-care things, right? Like I write down, you know, try not to be too stressed out. Make sure you go to like a workout class. You know, try to go for a walk. I'm really not doing great with my exercising lately. I know that I could be better. And so that's definitely a goal of mine moving forward. I think I started getting into the decorating portion of the spread now, and I ended up finding, I don't think I found too many really large stickers. I got quite a few of stickers this time from my Pip stickers, and that is going to be coming up here in a few seconds. I ended up also using, I think I used kind of quite a bit of words, like just script, that I put across the page. You can see at the top right side, I already have one that says like Creative Spark. I did find probably a handful more of little script stickers like this. So this one says enjoy every moment and it has some palm trees on it. I ended up layering a really beautiful gold foil flower sticker on top of that. And yeah, I really love this. I had a great time talking to my girlfriend. And we actually tried to catch up, you know, regularly in this. 2020 was rough. I didn't talk to her nearly as much. But once we were able to get back into it, you know, I make it a point to really nurture my female friendships and to recognize that, you know, those are important and you have to put the effort into it. And I make a schedule. I put it on these spreads. I think I may have put it on like my August and September spreads to, you know, contact my girlfriends regularly. And I have done the thing in the past where I just pick a random day. Maybe I pick after I have my appointments and my assignments, I might pick a day that doesn't have too much going on. And I will say to, you know, send a few people a text message. And I am also a person who will send like multiple people will get, photos of like my youngest started playing lacrosse. And so I sent a bunch of my girlfriends and of course my family members, but I include my girlfriends in that and sharing what's going on with our lives and, you know, to be able to maintain that. And sometimes it sparks a conversation and sometimes it doesn't. And I don't think either one of us, me or my friend, is like offended or hurt if it does not spark a long conversation. Sometimes we text back and forth, you know, a few sentences. Sometimes we text back big paragraphs. Because we live all over the world, because we don't live, you know, we don't even live close to being in the same time zone. One of my closest friends just moved to Idaho, and I don't know if she's 9 hours or 8 hours behind me. So sometimes when I text her, I know it's the middle of the night for her. And I'm like, I know that your phone's turned off, so I don't have a problem sending a message. So that's really a nice thing to do, right? Is to make sure you schedule that, make sure you take the time and be on purpose with your staying in touch with people. Because especially as we move around so often, you have to. Like, you have to do it on purpose. I actually did a video. Oh, it wasn't a class. I suppose it's like a workshop. I did a video workshop recently with a quilting friend who I met. Oh my goodness. I can't even tell you how long ago I met some of these women. To one of the women who was leading the workshop, and then another one of the participants. Definitely, coming up on like 7, 8 years ago, possibly even longer than that. And so seeing them in that workshop, it was just a nice little moment to be like, wow, I haven't seen you for so long. And, where do you live now? And what's going on? And so that was really cool to be able to see them and to be able to do that. So I mentioned I did some layering of my stickers, and you can see that I put that plant on top of the Get Busy sticker. So a little bit of that like yellow mustardy color is popping through the pot that the plant is in. And I don't know at what point I stopped looking through the books and just got out my Pip stickers, because I did end up using just a ton of plant stickers from the Pip stickers. And the Pip stickers are really good quality. They are like a nice, good, thick sticker. I don't know. It's clear, and they just look really good on the page. I really am enjoying like layering these and making these spreads look, I don't know, just like so involved, and it just looks so good. I'm looking at I'm watching this video and I'm just like, oh, this is just making me so happy, like all over again. You know what I mean? So I love it. I love bullet journaling. I've been doing this for years, and I hope that you are able to get some inspiration from this. I would love if you started doing, or if you are already doing, 2-page monthly spreads. Put a link to your Instagram or something in the comments so I can check it out, because I'm not only interested in seeing, I mean, I think I'm always looking for inspiration too, right? Like, what else is out there? I was probably very likely inspired by somebody to do this, although at this point, I honestly don't remember. So, if you've seen somebody else do this, then I think that that's awesome. So, I hear you see me laying down some more scripts. The one on the right page says, I can, I will. And then I did cover up the grocery list words with make it happen. So that looks really cool. And then this one here says, gather, give, grow. Kind of a fitting statement for a spread that ended up using tons and tons of plant stickers and leaves and stuff like that. So it looks really good. Let's see, what else is going on? I am currently in the middle. Am I in the middle? I think I'm in the middle to almost to the end of my. No, I'm not to the end. I'm in the middle. I'm solidly in the middle of my semester. And like I said before, I'm taking 2 classes this time. And I think my semester's over at the end of October. And then I get a week off, maybe 10 days. And then next semester, like I said before, it's an accelerated semester, so it's really short. It is a ton of work because it's a master's level class. So it's just a lot of reading and a lot of writing. And these spreads are keeping me sane as I look back on them. So as you're seeing this, I'm in the middle of my fall semester, and I am halfway finished with 2 courses. Next semester, I'm only taking one. So that will be kind of like a nice break. And then I'm not sure what I'm taking for the spring yet. I don't have to register for that just yet. Probably we won't register until maybe November. I'm not sure how that goes, actually, now that I say that out loud. So here you see me getting out the Pip stickers, and I did sort these into sizes. I sorted the stickers into 4. I think there's 4 distinct sizes, or maybe there's 5 that Pip Stickers uses, and I put them into my one of my little binders that has my stickers in it, and then I'm able to just pull them out by the size. And there might be 5 because I think one of them is like a washi tape kind of situation, and I don't really use a ton of washi tape in my spreads in general. I might give those away. I need to go back and look at that because you saw me organize my stickers already, and I do have that big pile. I'm actually leading a program at the USO. I'm the co-lead for the military spouse programs at my local USO. And we are doing a workshop in September for Let's see, I think it's gonna be a travel scrapbook, but in January, I am actually going to do a bullet journal class. So I'm super ready for that. I think it's going to be really cool. I got to pick out the supplies to order. I ordered notebooks and black pens, and then I ordered a couple packages of colored pens, or maybe I did highlighters, so that people can have a little bit of color in their spreads. And then also we were able to order sticker books for people to use. So that's going to be really cool to be able to show them how to do bullet journaling and show just, you know, there's such a big wide variety and ways that you can do this. There's the skinny strips, and the other skinny strips that you saw briefly are the washi tape ones that I don't necessarily use all the time. So for these stickers, I did get out a ton of the, I would say, small to tiny stickers to kind of just put them all over the spread. Lots of flowers and plants, and I think a couple of the here we go. And this one, they're like little pillows, like little square cushions. So that's just kind of like a cute little decoration, and just kind of stuck them everywhere. This is my fill in the blanks. Where do I have space? What fits here? What's going to look good? You know, kind of thing. I think that that little sticker was crooked, and I don't know if my pen helped me make it straight or not. But I love this part. I mean, I appreciate that I'm able to find the larger stickers to be able to write on, like to put my things on each month, but filling in this little last part is so fun. Look how good it looks. Oh, I love this. There is some foil, there's some layering, there's plenty of space for you to write out everything for your month. So we're coming up to the end. I hope you have enjoyed this. Like I said, please leave a comment if you do the same thing. Be sure you like and subscribe for more bullet journal videos from me. Here is my October spread. Have a great day.